think about the tools you wouldn't survive without. The television that acts as a hub for gaming and binge-watching. Your smartphone, which you frequently check. The camera you bring on all of your vacations. Each owes its influence to a single model that permanently altered the direction of technology. Let's take a look at a few of these die-hard technologies that have not changed much in the past century. Number 20, computers. Although they appear to be a relatively recent innovation, computers have been around since the early 1800s. They were once incredibly big and slow in their most basic form, but they've since evolved to be smaller and faster, allowing people to use them almost anywhere. There hasn't been a single pioneering innovator or first computer in the history of computers. Numerous mathematicians and scientists built on one another in order to gradually create the computer. But the 1930s are when the modern computer was first developed. They haven't changed much since then, have they? Number 19, vacuum cleaners. Ives W. McGaffey created the first vacuum cleaner, or motorized carpet sweeper, in 1868. The first powered vacuum cleaner wasn't produced until 1901, despite the fact that inventors had long since achieved significant advancements to increase cleaning effectiveness, mobility, and accessibility. Till now, the fundamental components of a vacuum are the same: a fan, a brush, a filter, and a bag. You can upgrade to a more powerful fan or a better filter, but the fundamental principles remain the same. Number 18, camera. Early cameras were large and heavy, requiring long exposure times and a lot of light to produce a high-quality image. Today's digital cameras have virtually eliminated film and turned everyone into a photographer. Since professional quality photos can now be taken with just a timer button and a selfie stick, it's difficult to foresee where cameras will go from here. The fact that pictures as we know them now were still in their experimental stages just over 200 years ago, however, is remarkable. Number 17, steam turbine. Heron of Alexandria, a mathematician and engineer, created the steam turbine in the 1st century AD and gave it the name Eolipile. It had the ability to activate two hollow tubes that brought steam from a cauldron to the sphere. The steam would then escape from hollow, curved tubes, forcing the machine to spin rapidly. Even now, about 150 years later, turbine-based generation is the predominant technique for producing power all over the world. However, the turbine concept hasn't altered much at all. Number 16, internal combustion engine. The internal combustion engine's operating concept hasn't changed in a century. Gasoline and air are injected, the cylinders explode, and power propels you forward. But every year, experts improve internal combustion engines to make them run faster and quicker. Despite the growing popularity of electric vehicles, gas and diesel vehicles continue to dominate the market, so it's obvious that internal combustion engines will remain in use for at least a bit longer. Number 15, television. Over the past century, TVs have undergone several changes. High-definition flat displays with a wide variety of material have replaced the bulky box with three channels and poor images that once was the norm. In 1924, Scottish engineer John Logie Baird invented the first functional TV using any materials he could find, including wax, cardboard, and a bicycle lamp. Today, TVs are way more better looking, thanks to a century of history and progress. Number 14, stethoscope. The first stethoscope was developed in the early 1860s by a French physician named René Leonec, using a rolled-up paper tube as a funnel to avoid placing his ear on the patient's chest to hear her heartbeat. This not only fixed the issue, but Dr. Leonec also noticed that it amplified the sounds coming from the woman's chest. Although there are now small, portable gadgets that can give a more thorough picture of what's happening in the chest region, there are still some circumstances when a stethoscope is more suitable. Number 13. Bicycle. The fact that bicycles haven't changed all that much is one of their outstanding qualities. About two centuries have passed since the invention of the simple bicycle, and by the early 1900s, the basic principles of what we use today were already in place. Although the parts and materials have improved, the fundamental structure has not changed till date. Number 12, printing press. The printing press has long been regarded as a feat of human creativity. Books and other printed materials used to be handwritten. Monks would spend years meticulously copying down the Bible page by page, so needless to say, it was a long and taxing procedure. However, the printing press made it possible to manufacture print media more quickly and at a lower cost. The history of printing is filled with countless individual improvements, tweaks, and techniques, but the headliners have remained the norm for almost another century. Number 11. Plow. The ability to grub up fields with tree branches or roots dates back to the beginning of agriculture in the Middle East. However, when farming extended to Northern Europe's heavier soil, a more durable solution was needed. The early heavy plow was modeled after the carruka, which included a blade for digging the ground and a moldboard for turning the furrow over. It was drawn by oxen or horses and eventually helped bring about the agricultural revolution. Plows are now, however, pulled by tractors on modern farms. Number 10. Clocks. Although time-telling tools have been around for a very long time, the 60-minute, 60-second system that we still use today was developed by the Sumerians in 2000 BC. Early clocks used the sun's or the water's movement to roughly tell the time. We're also familiar with timers, candle clocks, and hourglasses. The mechanical clock then followed, which had a water-powered escapement system that turned the gears. Keeping time has become a fairly precise technique in the modern era, thanks to quartz oscillators and atomic clocks. Number 9. Seismoscope. The ability to identify earthquakes before they occur is becoming more and more sophisticated each year, saving lives in the process. The technology might not be all that new, though. The Hufeng Didongyi, a seismoscope, was the first earthquake-detecting tool known to history, and it dates back to 2,000 years ago in ancient China. The first earthquake detection technology isn't all that far from modern models, in terms of design. The only difference is that it was made before anyone even knew what an earthquake actually was. Number 8. Odometer. The odometer was created in 15 BCE by Vitruvius, a Roman architect and engineer according to the Encyclopedia Britannica. It had a standard-sized chariot wheel that revolved 400 times in a Roman mile and was set on a frame with a cogwheel with 400 teeth. The cogwheel engaged a mechanism that dropped a pebble into the box once every mile. So, counting the stones, you might determine how far you had traveled. The odometer of today also counts the distance covered by a car, machine, or other moving object. However, the original device's concept was so good that it took more than 1,500 years to simplify and improve its design until it resembled what we know it to be today. Number 7. Fax machine. You will either be relieved or embarrassed to learn that fax machines are still in use if you're old enough to remember them. A single sheet of paper could be sent as a picture using a fax machine to any location in the world, assuming that location also had the large cube that could receive faxes. Fax machines were nearly completely replaced everywhere by printers and email in the late 90s because they were unreliable, unsightly, and expensive to maintain. Well, everywhere except hospitals. Number 6. Compass. Nearly all of humankind's navigational needs over the last 1,000 years have been met by the magnetic compass. In search of something more dependable, mariners in China and Europe independently found lodestone, a magnetic material that aligned with the North Pole in the 12th century. This discovery put mankind on the path to map the entire planet. Despite having easy access to GPS technology, traditional magnetic compasses are still often used till date. A Brunton compass is used by geologists when conducting fieldwork. They're still present on ships, too. Number 5. Safety razor. Although the safety razor has been around for a while, it hasn't always had the same appearance. The earliest real razors may be traced back hundreds of years to ancient Egypt. However, a French inventor did not add a safety guard to straight razors until the 18th century, and the safety razor did not appear for another 100 years. Safety razors are now more well-rounded, more durable, and more water-resistant thanks to new breakthroughs in materials like carbon fiber, aluminum, and more. Number 4. Armored car. In 1485, the renowned artist Leonardo da Vinci drew numerous armor-plated transport units. The armored vehicle, which could have been a forerunner of the tank, could move in all directions and would have been armed with cannons. But it wasn't until World War I that many nations began putting armor plating on their cars in order to defend themselves from the barrage of new ammunition and powerful rifles. And these days, car manufacturers are increasingly producing specially designed armored vehicles for their wealthy clientele. Number 3. Battery. Luigi Galvani, an Italian physicist, observed that a dead frog's leg will twitch when grazed by two pieces of metal in the 1780s. His friend, the aristocratic professor Alessandro Volta, picked up on the phenomena, and Napoleon was astounded by Volta's voltaic cells placed in a voltaic pile. This pile served as the very first battery, and now more than a third of the devices on this list are powered by its descendants. Our phones and PCs were powered by batteries in 2010. Now, more than 10 years later, they also power our homes and cars. Number 2. Calculators. The Canon Pocketronic calculator, which cost $345 when it was released, a cool $2,165 today, was designed around three circuits that let it perform addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. The calculations were powered by 13 rechargeable battery cells that were jam-packed within the case, and the results were printed on thermal paper. Today, there are more than 250 calculator models available in stores and online, with prices ranging from a few dollars to more than $700 for a fully functioning graphing calculator. Number 1. Phones. The development of mobile phones began in the late 1960s and continued throughout the 1970s. These, however, had to be driven in vehicles because they were too heavy to be considered really mobile. Consumer expectations for smartphones have completely shifted thanks to modern cell phones, particularly the Apple iPhone. The phone has become a virtual toolbox with an app for practically every requirement thanks to the App Store. But smartphones may undergo yet another significant transformation in the future. According to the World Economic Forum, the first implanted phones will be marketed by 2024. That's all I have for you today. Why not check out your home or workplace for similar technologies? You could be surprised by how long they've been around.